Hi, I'm Manfred from the bada team of Samsung Mobile. In this video, we in the bada team will present some of the great new features introduced in bada 2.0. We'll explain the important new namespaces and classes, walk you through code, show you examples running in the emulator and on a device, and introduce you to some new tools to help your development. So first up, here is Keith to tell you about the new UX features.
We're particularly excited about two new features introduced in the UIX namespace, text-to-speech and speech-to-text. Text-to-speech lets you convert normal text language into speech. Maybe you want to read a book on your phone, but you're too tired to read the screen. With text-to-speech, you can have your device read to you. Implementing text-to-speech functionality is easy. Let's take a look at an example. The first thing we do is create, then construct, an object of the class text-to-speech, which is part of the UIX namespace. Then we call initialize to set up the service. One thing you need to know is that to use either text-to-speech or speech-to-text, you must have a network connection. If you do not have a network connection, the initialization will fail. To get your device to actually speak, you need to implement the iText-to-speech event listener. And in the onText-to-speech status change handler, wait for the text-to-speech service to be initialized. Then everything's set and you can call the speak method.
Hello, bada.
By default, text-to-speech uses US English, but you can use the setLocal method to change the type of voice used. Currently, text-to-speech supports UK English, German, French, Spanish and Italian. You also have control over other settings too. You can choose a female voice with the set voice type method and choose the speech rate.
Bonjour bada.
The speech to text feature lets you translate spoken words to text, so you can control your application using your voice, write a dictation app, or even do language translation. Speech-to-text is implemented using the Speech-to-text class, which is part of the UIX namespace. First, you create an object of the Speech-to-text class, then construct, and finally call initialize. Like text-to-speech, speech-to-text requires a network connection, and you need to ensure that the service is initialized before it starts working. To handle speech-to-text related events, you need to implement the iSpeech-to-text event listener. The onSpeech-to-text initialize handler is then called when the service is initialized. You can then call the start method to start recording the speech to process. Once you're done, call stop, and when the speech service has finished processing, you'll be sent the result in the onText-to-speech completed method. Here's the speech-to-text note-taker sample running in the emulator. We'll start recording, speak some words, and wait to see the result.
This is a test of the speech-to-text.
This is a test of the speech-to-text.
You also have control over a number of settings, so you can choose how to process silence, grammatical settings, and even the profanity filter. Now here's Samir to tell you about another important new feature, multitasking.
Setting up your application to support multitasking is easy. In the IDE, go to Project, Properties, Application Information, scroll to the bottom of the window, and click Multitasking checkbox. It only makes sense for the certain types of tasks to run in the background, such as playing music, monitoring sensors, and updating location information. Any application which doesn't need to run in the background shouldn't have multitasking enabled. Memory management becomes more of an issue with lots of apps running. To ensure your app works correctly in the multitasking environment, you need to write some additional code. If a bada device is running low on memory and your app is running in the background, your app may be forced to quit. You will need to implement the iAppCheck point event listener to save the application state when your app is terminated, usually in such a low memory conditions. In the onAppCheck pointing handler, you will get a chance to write information out to the registry or the other files, so that nothing is lost when your app terminates. Apps can now exchange messages using inter-application communication. This is implemented by new classes in the I/O namespace: Channel Manager, Client Channel, and the Server Channel, as well as the Listener classes for the channel-related events. You set up channels between your application using their app IDs and can send data between the specified group of apps.
We have two applications, Client and Server. In the Client application, we press the Request button to send a request to the server. The Server application receives the request, logs it, and sends the response back to the Client app. The Client app receives the response and displays the data in the form. Now let's see how we implement this functionality in the code. On pressing the Request button, we send a request to the server using server's app ID. The server form is derived from the iChannel request event listener and receive request in the onChannel request received end method. On receiving request from the Client application, we prepare the response and send it back using the send response method. The Client's form class is derived from the iChannel response event listener. It receives responses from the server in the onChannel response received and callback method.
Here is my good friend Cheng to tell you all you need to know about NFC and bada 2.0.
Another great new feature in bada 2.0 is support for NFC, near field communication technology. First, I want to introduce the basic technology side of NFC. Then I will focus on what you can do with NFC on bada, show you some code and a demo. In this demo, I will show you how to read information from an NFC tag. The starting point for implementing NFC is the NFC Manager class. After you have created an object of the NFC Manager class, you then need to add two listeners, one to enable you to find the NFC tag, and the other to detect in-depth records on the tag. Once you have prepared your NFC Manager object, you can start to check the activation status of NFC. When we know the status of the NFC sensor, we can then start operations such as detecting the NFC tags and reading information. Let's begin with detecting the tags. Once you've added the tag detection listener to the NFC manager object, the on NFC tag detected and callback will be called automatically. What we did first was to check whether the connection supports the in-depth message operation. This is the most common NFC standard. Then we set the in-depth tag listener to this connection and started to read from the tag. Once we got the tag connection from the on NFC tag detected and callbacks and set the in-depth tag connection listener, we can get the in-depth record from the on in-depth read completed and callback. Since NFC is designed for short-range communication between NFC devices, the read and write operation happened right after the tag was detected and without any authentication or pairing process. So if the tag contains in-depth records, the result will be returned in on in-depth read completed and callback. It is possible that one NFC tag contains multiple in-depth records. You can use getRecordsCount and get record at from the in-depth message class to retrieve all the records. The write process is almost the same as the read process for the NFC tags.
So here's the NFC tag, which we pre-programmed the URL as the in-depth record. Then we launched the sample code called tag reader, and we click the read the tag. And once the device detects the tag information, it shows the payload information of the tag, which is the URL, of course. And then we can connect it, the URL, using the Dolphin browser.
In part one, we introduced you some of the new features in bada 2.0. We showed you the new text-to-speech and speech-to-text classes, the great new multitasking features, and of course, NFC. Stay tuned for the part 2, where you will look at the new web development technologies, UI features, and some of the new tools. Thanks for watching.